All right. So the Adventure Campus program, it gets planned throughout the entire year. We have full-time staff that works on the registration and planning of the program. So a lot of time goes into planning a before and after school program of this size across 3 different districts and 5 different sites. So we're all going to introduce ourselves really quick. My name's Mary Mucci. I'm a recreation supervisor here at the Northbrook Park District. I oversee the Adventure Campus program, some special events, as well as summer camps during the summer. I started with the district back in March, so I got to oversee the tail end of last school year's Adventure Campus. Before coming to the Northbrook Park District, I worked full-time doing before and after school programs at Morton Grove Park District, and I also did all the aquatic programming in the summertime for Morton Grove. So I'm excited to be here in Northbrook and tackle this position of running Adventure Campus.
Thank you. Sorry, I couldn't find my unmute button, even though we've been doing this for a year and a half. Hi, everyone. My name is Katie Kotlowski. I'm a Recreation Division Manager here at the Northbrook Park District. My headshot from our website looks a little bit different. I have blonde hair now, but it is still me, I promise. I have been at the Park District for almost 5 years. And I have always been the supervisor for the person who runs our Adventure Campus program. So my office is here at the Leisure Center, and I am always available for you if you have questions, if Mary's not available, or if there's anything else I can help you with. I'll turn it over to Wendy.
Hi, I'm Wendy Friedman. I'm the office supervisor over at the Leisure Center. We do registration. I handle the billings for Adventure Campus. So if you have billing questions, I'm always a good person to call. Usually could straighten it out for you. I've been with the Park District for 26 years, and I enjoy helping all you guys get through all your stuff. So I look forward to working with you this year.
We also have Erin Sweet on this phone call. I don't have her picture here. She's going to help us. Just let me know if we have any questions in the chat. And yeah, help us enter anyone who comes in late. And then Wendy's going to talk briefly about some payment information regarding Adventure Campus.
Okay, so we've already started our billings for Adventure Campus. When you signed up, you paid your first payment, which was for the few days that we have in August. We always pay a month ahead. So your August 2nd payment was paying for September, and then September's will pay for October, and so on. If you need to change anything, you would call our office and we would discuss any changes. But the payments usually come out on the 2nd of every month, and they go through May, I believe. That you'll be automatically billed. And that's about it, unless you have questions.
Yes, so if you have any questions about schedule changes or payment information, please contact Wendy Friedman. And you can do that by just calling our main line. So now I have some important dates and contact information you'll need before the school year starts. So we have on Monday, August 16th, all your parent information will be due in EPACT. Everyone should have received a link from EPACT to complete your online form. I'm going to go over exactly what EPACT is and what information that includes in a future slide. But basically what EPACT is where we store all our contact information for each child, any allergies, medications that your children take, who's allowed to pick up your child from Adventure Campus. So it's very important information that we need before you start Adventure Campus in just about a week. So District 27 and District 31, so Hickory Point, Shaboni, and Winkleman, start next Thursday on the 19th. So that's coming up really quick, and we're really excited to have your kids back at school. And then later on September 2nd, District 30 will be starting with Willowbrook and Westcott on the 2nd. So I'm going to pause on this slide really quick. This is our direct contact information that you, if you ever need to get a hold of the Adventure Campus site. So please take time here to find your child's school and save the phone number that is on the screen. This phone number, your site director at each school will have a phone on them at all times. So if you're running late to pick up your child, if your kid's going to be absent that day, you can call or text this phone number to let staff know any information they need to know about your child, or if you just need to get a hold of some, get a hold of staff that's with your child. So go ahead and take the time to save this phone number, and we'll go over in future slides what the site phones are used for. Each school also has an email, so you can save this email address as well. So you can always use the email and phone number to let staff know that your child will be sick, or if you're going to be running late or picking up a child early on a certain day. And these phone numbers and emails will also, they're in the parent handbook that was emailed to you, and it's posted on our website.
Okay. I'm going to pop in for just a second. There was a comment in the chat box saying, just making sure that my kids will be at Hickory Point and not at the Leisure Center this year. My kindergartner was at the Leisure Center last year, so just making sure. And yes, that is true. Your kindergarten students at, who are enrolled at Hickory Point will be at Hickory Point this year until someone tells any of us any different, which I'm hoping is never. Because we know you guys want to be at your school, and we want to be able to have programs here at the Leisure Center. So yes, you're at Hickory Point unless there's some other communication that comes out.
Katie, did Thanks, you see Mary. The other one asking about September 3rd for kindergarten as well? Could you address that?
Oh, I did. As far as I know, all programs for District 30 are starting on September 2nd. But I'm going to look into that while Mary is speaking.
Thank you. Okay, so our Adventure Campus program, we have an AM program and a PM program. So before and after school for all districts, 27, 30, and 31. This year we are offering before care for District 30 before the school did before school, but now the Park District will be taking it over for District 30 as well. So the before school program starts at 7 a.m. and runs to the start of your child's school day. And the after school program starts right when school is over. And you can pick them up anytime from after school, anytime before 6 p.m. So for the before school program, once the first bell rings for dismissal, a school staff member will be picking up your child from the Adventure Campus room and bringing them to their classroom. And then after school, the school gets sent a roster of which children attend Adventure Campus each day. And they will be taking your children who are on the list for the day to the Adventure Campus site after school. So once your children get to the program after school, we usually just check in the kids for attendance. We provide a nut-free snack every day. At the start of the program, we offer quiet time so children can work on their homework. If they don't have homework, they can read a book. We'll have crafts planned out as well for maybe like the kindergartners who don't necessarily get homework each day. And then with the Adventure Campus program, each week we have a new fun theme. So we'll have activities that are based off our weekly theme. So we'll be doing crafts and activities based on the theme, or we'll go outside to the playground or gym to do activities out there. In the mornings, we focus more on kind of a mindful morning. So our site directors are already planning some activities for the morning care, and they do, one of our site directors was talking about doing some morning yoga with the kids. We also provide a breakfast snack. So we'll have like breakfast bars, go-go squeeze. We have yogurts as well for the kids. Okay, so pickup and drop off. Each site has a different location where you can pick up and drop off your kid. So really quick, I'm going to show you where all these maps can be located so you can see where you will be picking up and dropping off your child. Let me just exit this screen so I can show you directly on our website. Okay, so you will start by going to the Northbrook Park District website, which brings you here. You can select programs and scroll down to our before and after school here, which brings you to our Adventure Campus website. Here we have something that's called Campus Chatter. So you'll be able to select, so if your child goes to Hickory Point, you can select Hickory Point School.
Hey, Mary.
And here, yeah.
Your screen is not showing up. All we see is your desktop.
Can you see it now? Perfect. Let me just start over. So if you go to the Northbrook Park District website, nbparks.org, you will then select programs, before and after school care, which brings you to our Adventure Campus webpage. So if your child attends Hickory Point, you will select Hickory Point. And then here you'll see the pickup and drop off map. So where you will drop off your kid each day and pick up your kid from Adventure Campus. We also have the parent handbook posted online, as well as a calendar of the days your child is off of school. And we will be posting monthly newsletters to this page as well. So this page is called Campus Chatter. Okay. Oops. Okay, so once you locate your school's map, you'll see where you can drop off your kids and pick up your child. Our school districts are asking us this year to have minimal adults in the building as possible. So if you were in the Adventure Campus program last year, we'll be doing pickup and drop off the same way. So for AM care, once you arrive to the door, you're supposed to be dropping off your child. You will call the site phone, which I gave you in a previous slide. And you'd call and just say, hi, this is so-and-so. I'm here to drop off, and say your child's name. One of our staff will open the door and allow your child in for the program. For after school, once you arrive at the school, you're a few minutes away, you can call that same phone number and say you're here to pick up your child. And then our staff will then bring your child out to the car. We are going to be checking IDs at pickup for the first few weeks, just until we get to know your car, get to know who the adults are for your child each day. So in EPACT, you can enter who's allowed to pick up your child. So we'll just be checking their IDs each day to make sure that whoever's picking up your child matches who's on their emergency form. So they have to be on the authorized pickup list. If you need to make an update to that list, you can log into EPACT at any time and add people to pick up your child.
Mary, can they text the number or should they be calling the number?
Yes, you can text or call the number. But please make sure that you're putting your child's name on there so they know who to expect. If you are running late for whatever reason, it happens, so we're going to be as understanding as possible. You can also give a call or text to the phone to say that you're running late. We do ask the first time, we might be a little lenient, but if it becomes something that's regular and you're running late each day, you will get charged $10 for every 10 minutes you're late. So please be contacting the site director so they know where you are. So that your child has to be picked up by 6 p.m. each day. So every 10 minutes after that, you will get charged an additional fee, and that will automatically get uploaded to your account and be involved in your monthly payment. If you are not picking up your phone at 6 p.m. and your child is still there, we will then go to your child's EPACT form and call the other people who are authorized to pick up your child. Okay, reporting absences. So like I said, you can call or text your Adventure Campus site phone. Our site directors will be receiving messages and checking that phone during program hours. So if it's like noon or something and you have to contact that site phone, our staff won't be checking the phone until about 2:30. So you might not get a reply right away, but once our staff gets to work that day, they'll respond to any emails, text messages, and phone calls. If your child is sick from school, they will not allow to be attending the Adventure Campus program that evening. So if they're home from school sick, you cannot bring them back to school for the Adventure Campus program. Your child must be fever-free for at least 24 hours. And please let the site phone know if your child will not be there. And we'll go ahead and confirm with the school as well to see who and who was not there that day. But it's super important that we know where your child is so we don't think they're missing after school. Okay. And if your child is in any clubs after school, they can still attend the Adventure Campus program after their club is over. So if they're in an after school program that runs till 4:30, please let the site director and you can let me know as well that your child will be coming to the Adventure Campus program late. We do ask that you ask the child's club supervisor or coach to escort them to the Adventure Campus program after their club is over. Our staff is not able to leave the program to go pick up your child from a different location in the school. So at each of our sites, our staff consists of site directors, counselors, and NSSRA staff. So our site directors lead the program each day. So they plan daily activities, they oversee the counselors at their site, and they will be the ones who are in charge of the site phone and communicating with you guys daily. They'll communicate to you about anything that's happened in the program that day, whether it's a conflict that happened with another student, if they had a really great day, they'll let you know, or if your child had a great day, they'll let you know, or if they were down, the site directors are there to communicate anything that happens at Adventure Campus with you. Our counselors for the after school program, they're there to lead activities that the site director plans, and they are in charge of supervision with different groups. So some counselors, your children will be divided up by age. So we might have kindergartners and first graders together, second and third graders together, fourth and fifth graders together. So our counselors will be in charge of supervising each group. And then our NSSRA staff is there to provide children who with special needs any additional support they'll need in the program. If you have a child who needs any additional support, please contact Nancy. She's our NSSRA liaison and her contact information is in the parent handbook. You can also reach out to me too if you think this is something that your child will need. So now we're going to get into personal medical information. We'll start with the COVID-19 guidelines. I'm sure everyone has questions about this. We will be following all school and state guidelines for the Adventure Campus program. So whatever the school is following, we will follow as well. I've been in communication with each of the principals to make sure that we're on the same page to keep our children as safe as possible. As of right now, masks are required for all staff and children in the program. The children are required to be three feet apart and 6 feet apart while eating. So we will be following these guidelines. EPACT. So I know I've already talked a lot about EPACT. This is our secure emergency network. We use this, like I said before, to collect medical information and emergency contact information for your children. If you have multiple children in our program, you will have to complete an EPACT form for each of your children. This replaces any of the paper forms that we've used in the past, and it's really handy because each site director on their site phone has the EPACT app, and at the touch of a fingertip, they have any information they'll need to know about each child in the program. If you have not received an invitation, please email me after this meeting and I'll send you another link to sign up for EPACT. Okay, medications. So if your child has any allergies or allergy medication or medications that need to be taken during the program, you will need to fill out the permission to dispense oral medication, and that is in your EPACT form, all electronic. So if your child has an EpiPen or if there's a certain medication your child has to take at a certain time, please enter it in EPACS and please communicate that with me as well as the site director. We will do everything we can to make sure that we have everything we need in case of an emergency with your child. So we'll have your EpiPens on file in a secure lockbox at each site. All medication will be locked up, and please make sure when you drop off medication on the first day of school that it's in its original container with your child's name and the dosage. Injuries. So all our staff is first aid and CPR certified. So they'll be trained, and they've also been trained for detecting concussions. So anything that happens to your child in the Venture Campus program, our staff is prepared to deal with anything from minor injuries to a head injury. So we will make sure that you are contacted right away from the site phone if anything were to happen to your child. If it's just like a paper cut or something like that, we'll tell you at the end of the day. But if it's if your child bumps their head on the playground or gets stung by a bee, we'll let you know. And our staff is prepared and everyone has their own first aid kit on them at all times. So we will always make sure that your kids are safe. And if something happens, our staff is prepared to deal with any injuries. If for some reason, knock on wood, if something happens to your child and they need to go to the hospital, we will call you, we will call 911, and one of our staff will ride in the ambulance with your child. Okay, days off school. So I'm going to be talking about emergency closures, days off school, winter breaks, spring breaks, and alternative options we have on that day when Adventure Campus is not running. So if for any reason, if the school has an emergency closure due to snow, a flood, a power outage, if the school is not in session, Adventure Campus will not be as well. So you can go ahead and check the emergencyclosingcenter.com to see if your school will be in session that day. If school is in session, so will be Adventure Campus will be as well. And if school is not in session, the program will be canceled as well. We will do our best to get an email to all parents regarding school closures as fast as we can. So District 30 only has half days throughout the year. So on these half days, if your child is enrolled in, so say if the half day is on a Friday and your child is signed up for Fridays at Adventure Campus, there is no additional fee. And we will offer the program from when school gets out at 11:45 all the way to 6 p.m. During this day, we might go to the movies. We might go to the batting cages and take a fun trip on this day as well. So pickup will still be between 3 p.m. and 6 p.m. And this will be taking place at your child's school. But from noon to 3 on certain days, we might take a trip. And parents will be emailed and informed as well. So on days that school is out, the Park District offers a few different options. So we have our Schools Out Fun program that's based out here at the Leisure Center on Walters. And that program goes from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. And we also have extended care options available from 7 in the morning to the start of the Schools Out program, and then from 3 p.m. to 6 p.m. on the Schools Day Out program. So these days we might take field trips. I already have on campus chatter, the page I showed you before, I have registration codes for each day that your child's out where you can already go up, go online and sign up for the days off school trips. Our first one is on September 7th and we will be going to Topgolf. So if you're interested in childcare on September 7th, the kids will be going to Topgolf. They have some fun youth games and lunches provided. There's also our Schools Out Sports Fun run out of TPAC. So that will also go from 9 to 3. Extended care options from 7 a.m. to 9 and 3 p.m. to 6 are also available. And this will be a sports-based camp. So break escapes. We offer a camp program during winter break and spring break for the kids. We have a few different options. We have a skate and dance camp. We have a sports camp. And we also have our regular break escapes where we'll be going on a field trip each day. And those field trips are listed in your parent handbook. And they're also listed on campus chatter under your school's day off calendar. And registration is already open for those days. Throughout the school year, you'll be getting a lot of communication from me. I will be emailing you reminders about days off school, half days, any changes to the program. For example, if the location's moved in from the gym to the library, you'll be notified. You'll be notified with any staff updates. And I will do my best to keep you in the loop about everything. Now we will take time for questions. If you have a question, you can go ahead and unmute yourself and ask, or you can go ahead and type it in the chat box.
We've gotten a lot of questions in the question and answer area and in the chat box. So we'll keep track of all of these. Some of them were private messages. Some of them were public question and answers. But we'll include the recap of all of the answers and the questions that were in here in the email that Mary's going to send out. That'll have the slides to the presentation and the recorded presentation that we're doing right now. There's a couple of questions that just came in. Have site directors been named for each school? Can you share their names? Mary, yes, please share their names.
As of yesterday, we finally have a site director at each site. I can send out more information regarding who the site directors are. If your child attended Adventure Campus at Shibone last year, Antonio Sanchez will still be our site director there. If your kindergartners attended the Leisure Center Adventure Campus program, we have Eve, who is the site director at the Leisure Center, who will be going over to Hickory Point PM. So any of your kindergartners will know who she is, and she's really excited to watch your kids grow into the first grade and get to meet the other kids over at Hickory Point. If your child attended Beyond the Bell Camp this summer, and she also subbed for some extended camp this summer, Heather Kopka will be our site director over at Willowbrook. We also have, he was a counselor for Adventure Campus for a few years. He was an assistant site director in 2019 at Willowbrook. His name is Matthew Boston. He will be over at Westcott School. And then Tanya Stroyov will be the AM site director over at Westcott. She's done AM camp with the kids here. She worked at Hickory Point a little bit last year. And then at Winkleman School, we have, her name is Larissa, and she was an assistant site director. She filled in as a site director for a few weeks when another one was out over at Winkleman School. So I will send a little bit more information out to you before the school year starts, but we just settled who our site directors are. So, and if you have any older kids who are in high school looking for jobs, we're still hiring counselors. So you can have them apply on our website.
A couple other questions that came up. Someone asked if there's options to use before school care once or twice a week, or does it need to be weekly? We've closed registration down right now just so we can plan for the school year. But if you need specific times of the month or days of the month that you need AM care or PM care, you can talk with Mary. We want to be as flexible as possible to get everyone care who could possibly need it this year. With all of our varying work schedules, we're just trying to be as flexible as possible. So if you have a unique scenario, please reach out to Mary and we'll do what we can. Someone asked if kindergartners get lockers. I don't know the answer to that question. That would be a question for the school. There are no lockers that we utilize during Adventure Campus. We talked about our site director names. Someone asked if we could talk more about the Willowbrook meet and greet on Thursday. We are hoping to have a table at that meet and greet on Thursday at both Willowbrook and Westcott. However, that's not totally set in stone yet. But as far as I know, that's for your student and the parent to meet your child's teacher. If we are able to be there, then you would be able to meet the site director that we have placed there and ask any questions specific to Adventure Campus. Not all schools are having this, so this is specific to District 30. And then someone asked about EPACT, if you have another child who is coming into the program. You're trying to connect the emergency contact to the second sibling. And says you tried to email earlier, but you haven't got a response yet. Probably for me, sorry about that. You need to accept the invitation for the second child, and each child, you would have gotten two emails or one email if, you know, just one of your child is new. The other one would have been a reconfirmation. So I probably have an email in my inbox from you to get that figure it out with you, and I will respond and walk you through that as well. Someone else has asked, how far in advance do days off, outings, and winter and spring break fill up? It's hard to say. This last year, we've had to cancel quite a bit of things. For spring break last year, we only had maybe 15 kids, I think. A lot of the school's day off programs either canceled or had very low enrollment. However, we are anticipating that a lot of parents are going back to working in person. So we're hopeful that we will get a lot more enrollment. My thought is always to register sooner than later. So we have a good idea of how many people to expect. We typically need at least 10 kids to run a program for a school's off, either field trip or an in-house event. Another person asked, should we have an extra set of clothes or any specific items available to keep at school? You can keep something in your child's backpack, but as far as school goes, we won't really hold any of the kids' personal belongings. I'm not sure what school prefers, if they keep it in their locker or in a cubby or something like that. But as far as Adventure Campus goes, you would just, if you felt like your child needed a change of clothes, I would just keep it in their backpack for them. I just did a lot of talking.
I also see a question about the meet and greet for Adventure Campus. I did send out an email. So the schools did ask us to limit parents into the building. So we did cancel the official Adventure Campus meet and greet with the site directors that was supposed to be on the 12th. But I know we just found out about District 30 holding something and possibly allowing parents in. So we'll see if there's something that we can reschedule or have someone at a table at that event.
We also just had a person ask about the enrichment activities. The question says, pre-COVID, the program used to bring in people for special activities like the magic show, yoga, et cetera. Are we bringing these back this year? Our hope is that yes, that we will be able to do that. At this time, all of the schools' guidelines set by the Illinois State Board of Education and the CDC are not allowing outsiders, I'll call them, or visitors into the school buildings. So we don't have those planned at this time, but we're hopeful that as soon as guidelines change or are lifted, we'll be able to add back our enrichment programming. Got some questions coming in. Are they carrying books back and forth from home to school? I'm not sure. Erin responded that would be a question for the school district. Someone asked, can you clarify the $25 charge to change the schedule? Does that apply applied to notifying you that we will be out for a week, for example. Typically the charge is for if you want to change your ongoing schedule. So you're not charged for, you're only charged for days that you registered for. It's not based on attendance. So if you're scheduled for every Monday for the whole school year, even if your child doesn't attend, you're going to be charged for that Monday that they were supposed to be in attendance. However, if you have a special scenario, something that is, you know, an illness or an injury or something like that where your child can't attend the program, please contact Mary. We want, like I said, to be as flexible as we can with any sort of schedule adjustments that we can be.
Someone was asking about the activities planned at Winkleman School. So our site director is already planning different activities. On our campus chatter, we'll get posted our different themes that we have each week. And our site director will keep the parents in communication about what activities they're doing. For example, if we have like a tie-dye day or something like that, when to bring in something white to decorate. We also have monthly newsletters going out that will notify important activities coming up where you might need to bring an item as a supply item. And we'll also be posting pictures and things like that of activities we have done at Adventure Campus.
Mary, we have a live question from Olga. It's not, Olga. Are you there, Olga? If you want to type the question, that's fine too.
Does anyone see any questions that we missed?
There are more questions about the Thursday meet and greet. If there's information on that and when you're going to send that out, how that's working.
So as of right now, we did have to cancel that Thursday meet and greet because the schools did ask us not to have parents in the building. And that's why we're doing pick up and drop off the way we are to limit the amount of adults coming into the building. So if the schools have changed their mind, we'll be in communication with the principals on finding a way to have you meet your site director before school starts. And that will be communicated through email.
Okay, we had a parent point out that our nbparks.org campus chatter page doesn't show there's a before school program for Willowbrook like the other schools show. Thank you for bringing that to our attention. We will fix it. Another parent asked, does the program go all the way from 3 to 6 or can we pick up any time between 3 and 6? You can pick up any time between the time they get out of school and the time of 6 o'clock. Same thing for morning drop-off, as long as you get them there before the bell rings for the first class in the morning, we will accept your child. And again, yes, you can pick up any time between 3 and 6.
Someone's asking if they can add future care dates that they're not currently signed up for, but they might need in the future, and how far in advance they'll need to sign up for that. If we have space in our program, you can go ahead and throughout the year, if you need additional child care, you can go ahead and sign up for additional dates as long as we have the space available.
Get a question asking, can the child take the bus home on some days? I'm assuming that means instead of going to Adventure Campus. And you would just need to notify the site director that your child is taking the bus home and will be absent from Adventure Campus.
You'll also probably need to arrange that with the school to make sure that they are on the transportation route. So as long as you have it worked out with the school, that can absolutely happen. A Okay, I've seen quite a few people drop off of our attendance. We had really good attendance tonight, though, so thank you so much, families, for coming out. Look out for a loaded email from Mary Mucci with all of the attachments and answers to your questions, and I will be getting back to those of you who have outstanding questions about EPACT. And if you don't get the answers that you need and the information that we send, please feel free to contact Mary or I or Wendy if it's regarding billing. And we are here to help you. We're looking forward to a great start of the year. Mary, do you have anything else to add?
No, I'm just very excited to get to know the kids and parents in this program. And I'm here whenever you need me.
All right. Thank you so much, everyone.